Hello friends and welcome back. So we're officially in 2020. That means we're in a brand new decade, and I wanted to take the time to kind of look back at the last decade and see kind of the anime that really influenced me and that really had significant meaning in my life. So in no particular order, I wanted to go through all the anime that really meant a lot to me this past decade. So the first anime that meant a lot to me was actually Umemiro Patissier. Now this is not a very popular or well-known anime and never got an English dub to it, but it is absolutely stunning. Being able to watch Umemiro Patissier really was a highlight to the beginning of the decade because it focused on that whole cooking aspect and the cooking with others and what you're cooking for and who you're making these sweets for, which I couldn't put into my food. Because it's cooking and it's something that I enjoy doing, it was a lot of fun to watch that anime and really be inspired by a lot of things in that anime. So after I experienced quite a few things in my life, I found Fairy Tail. I ended up really resonating with Fairy Tail and falling in love with Fairy Tail, and Fairy Tail became an absolute obsession of mine, and it really helped me in so many ways that I cannot describe. So it was probably the biggest impact of the decade was Fairy Tail, because it really impacted me quite a lot. It was so awesome, and it just helped me so much, and I love Fairy Tail for that reason, because it helped me so much. And then after that, we have the lovely Love Live. Now this had a great impact in my life because it became my life and absolutely everything. Other than Fairy Tail, Love Live became a huge obsession and really impacted me and changed my life in a lot of ways, because I really opened up and I really got to meet a lot of people because of Love Live, and it really expanded my world into the wonderful world of cosplay, which is the greatest hobby I could ever have, and I'm so happy to have it. And it's all because of Love Live. Well, I mean, there was other things, so it's not totally all because of Love Live, but Love Live had a really big influence in that. So Love Live was a huge, huge impact on me. Moving down the timeline, we also have Hakuto Pretty Cure. Hakuto Pretty Cure had a very big influence to me because I connected really well with Nona Hana. She is an amazing character, and I connected with her so much, and I found a lot of things that I really liked in her that I wanted to incorporate into my own life and stuff like that. And I thought she was an absolutely inspiring character. She became an inspiring character for me, and I found similarities of her and me and together in many ways. That whole anime became a big influence to me, and I absolutely adore it. For my last influence would have to be Black Clover. This one influenced me because it helped me realize to never give up. Which is Asta's biggest line in the whole anime. He constantly says, "I'm not done yet, I'm not done yet." So whenever you find yourself in like a tough spot, if you're like, remember what Asta said, and you're like, "I'm not done yet," it's just such an inspiring thing. It's the simplest words that you could think of, but just constantly repeating that every time you feel like you're overwhelmed or something like that, you just say, "I'm not done yet. I can keep going. I'm not done yet." And I found it so inspirational that I kept saying those lines to myself. And now I just, if I'm in a spot where I'm starting to feel really stressed, I say, "Hey, I'm not done yet. Let's just keep going." And I keep going. So that line, and Asta with that line, just was another great impact on me in the decade. So there has been some really amazing animes that have really influenced me and been a big part of my life, and that I've learned a lot. That's one thing that I love about anime so much, is that you can learn so many things from it, and it can really help you in life, and you can really take from that so many things and put it to your own life and move towards that, and use the "I'm never giving up" line to keep going, or the working as a team together to be an idol group, or a pretty cure who is fighting for the her friends and the things she loves and the things she cares about and the future that she's always imagined to have. And I think that's incredible. I think that is an incredible thing and one of the reasons that I love anime so, so much. So thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope you enjoyed it. What anime inspired you throughout the past decade? I'd love to hear from you. Let me know down in the comments. And as always, thank you so much for watching these videos. Remember to give it a thumbs up, as well as subscribe if you haven't. And until next time, I will see you later.